Welcome back to the Army of Two. It's Operation Nighthawk, where we need to protect an interceptor device.
We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
The Shadow Chamber said that we will encounter 6 enemies on this mission, including a codex, which we need to skulljack for our next objective, and including an unknown enemy.
Heading to that location.
Which should be
enemy patrol on the move.
Not one of these guys. It should be, unless I'm seriously mistaken, a sectopod. So I mean, obviously, I'm taking the high ground here. Unless those guys move into this direction. Let's take a look if anyone is up there. Okay, all clear. I think I'll play it safe and just move up here.
Got it covered.
Not sure who took the shot there. I should have like noted down which enemies we will see here.
Absolutely.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Cover's blows.
You did not just move right in front of me, right? You're not a smart guy.
Only the best. This might be useful.
So now please tell me that Fiona can reach the edge here. Cannot see the believe it. I mean, he can see him, so why shouldn't she be able to see him from, like, right next to him?
Heading out.
You know what I'm going to do?
Not a problem.
I know that this position has line of sight. Attention. Oh, okay, it's not just one codex, it's 2 of them. And I'm being marked. To do this, take out the officer.
What did you expect? My ammo's running low.
Take out this codex thanks to our blue screen rounds, or the one in the back, no, the one in the front.
the numbers. Ammo out.
And now it's time to gamble.
Heading out.
So moving back here. And back here. So my gamble now is, I want the codex to teleport up here and to use her rift ability. And hopefully she's close enough so I can then run up to her and skulljack. I mean, this all while keeping in mind that somewhere there's still a sector pod on this map. I think she just said they're trying to pull back, which means the codex did not fall for my trap and instead moved out to join up with the upper port. Which is terrible.
Ready to rock! Sure thing.
Overwatch. I'm on it.
I really wish I still had concealment. Really prefer to not walk into the sector pod on my turn. Something. Ouch. Worst thing that could happen right now is if suddenly the sector pod starts shooting the device. And the game is playing the combat music. I'll stay in position for one turn.
Shh. I think I heard something.
We all hear something. Certainly smashing something. I'll continue leapfrogging along this side here. Probably to that point.
What's making that noise?
Yeah. Can I get a look inside here? I think. Oh. Yeah, if there's like a sector pod shaped wall in a hole in the wall, that's a good sign that he might be there. Let's take one more Overwatch turn.
Moving to Overwatch.
Come get some.
We've got movement.
I mean, the scariest thing is that I have no idea how much health and armor a sector pod has here. So that will be interesting to see. The nice thing about sector pods is they usually aggressively move into your direction when you trigger them.
Heading out. Got it covered.
Overwatch.
Something exploded there.
On the way. We're near the objective.
Menace 1-5, we've got a line on the target. Move to protect that gear at all costs.
Hello.
The aliens used this to defeat most of Earth's heavy conventional forces. It can punch through armor just as easily as it chews through infantry. Be careful.
Now, interestingly, I think Mr. Sectopod had a run-in with a car and already lost some health. So that's good. That's a good start. So we can do 26 to 30 of chain shot. We're 100% to crit. That sounds like a shot I'm willing to take. So we did a total of 17 damage there. Now, for those of you paying attention, 27 damage. What I was about to say, yeah, if you would have been undamaged, you would have had 30 health, but he wasn't, so he didn't. So what do I do with those two guys? On the one hand, I could just run and gun, kill him, and use the implacable move to, like, GTFO, with more codex. But I kind of want to keep my run and gun for the turn where I hack the codex. Because of what happens when you hack the codex. Then again, I don't want to do a drawn out firefight here with those two. Don't want him to shield the codex either.
Set him up, knock him down.
Yeah, so we set him up and knock him down. It's a guaranteed kill. Thanks for playing. So, free action and a free move. I mean, I'm untouchable right now, so the codex can't really hurt me.
Sure thing.
So let's bait it to this side here. You're telling me I still have an action? I don't want to kill it. Yeah, just end the turn.
Cover the flanks!
Okay. That's that. Weapon unaffected. Now, the downside of skulljacking is that you cannot choose from where to skulljack, but I guess that would have been my choice. Anyway. Weapon unaffected.
This might sting a little!
So, yeah. Go, go, 10%! Oh.
I'm in.
Okay, big guy.
I believe we are seeing something entirely new. An alien species that has so far managed to elude capture or observation by resistance forces. I strongly advise a cautious approach.
Now this is exactly why I would have liked to have run and gun. I'm really surprised that he's this low. Like, come on. 16 health? No armor? I'm not sure if he's always a bit weaker in the story mission than in the final mission. But let's see if we can use our increased mobility here to maybe get some good shots. It's not enough for a flank. I mean, it would be if this car wouldn't be there. In this case, I'm not sure if moving up, if the range bonus outweighs the... Oh god, terrible. So let's think a second. I cannot negate his high cover. So I have 80 base aim, minus high cover is 40. Currently, due to the height advantage and weapon range, I get 10 bonus. So if I move like here, probably get... I lose 20 from the... on the height advantage, but I'm probably close enough to get 20 from weapon range, so that should be then a 60% to hit.
Not a problem.
Rough estimates. (clears throat) 59, close enough. Gonna take the rapid fire, see how it plays out. A miss.
Shot wide.
It's a crit, but not enough. Oh, he's burning. And he doesn't care about burning. He just teleported. Okay, that's the rift. Now the burning damage. Roll a 2, roll a 2, roll a 2. Oh, he regens. I actually wasn't aware that they regenerate health, because I always killed them first turn.
I can't even move.
Yeah, okay, so... again, a bit anticlimactic. He has so many, so awesome abilities, and then...
we're clean to go.
We have a 69% shot.
Head now.
Yeah. If that's the Avatar, then we really don't have to worry about the Avatar project.
What did you expect?
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
So that's that done. I'd say the best thing about it is that we can now take the Skulljack and put it in some drawer and never take it out again. Done all the Skulljacking we need to do for this campaign. And I'm pretty sure Fiona will be happy about that, that she can use that equipment slot for something... something a bit more useful. And we had our first encounter with a sector pod. And the scary thing here is that it's not really a guaranteed kill with the... even with blue screen rounds. Now chop on that, of that. I'm not sure if a car explosion shreds armor. So, because free armor sector pod
impressive work, Commander.
Seems a bit weak.
I firmly believe the specimen we have recovered is crucial to the aliens' efforts. We currently do not have the means of properly studying it.
New objective added.
So we'll see, I guess, the next time we encounter a sectopod,
my expectations were high,
how good or bad they are.
You have exceeded them.
I mean, talking about sectopods, we now have a specialist who could potentially haywire protocol sectopods. Ooh. I think the game really likes me here. That from above. Combat Hacker Specialist with Death from Above. It's really nice. But I don't think it will cut it. As I mentioned before, the normal weapon, I mean, she's using assault rifle here, but even the plasma gun, which we haven't even bought yet, we haven't upgraded the normal weapons yet, they're just not doing enough base damage. I mean, you see, like, most enemies have like 8 health or maybe 8 health and a point of armor or two, so you really need those 8 to 10 weapons, so the shotgun, the autocannon, or whatever it's called, and maybe the sniper rifle. But I'm really happy with our team so far, and I mean, both of these guys were on the first mission on Operation Gatecrasher.
Your troops encountered may be a critical piece of the Avatar project, Commander.
So replacing either of them seems just wrong. So let's get back to
Avenger
Intel.
Plotting new course.
I think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing.
Okay, instant shield bearer.
Physically,
autopsy.
These shield bearers are not all
gives
that
us the experimental
their
armor projects, which are,
the most
I think, a bit underwhelming. I mean, it might be interesting to have like the region armor or something like that, but not convinced that it's the right thing yet for us. So anything here we want. This is the Hellweave West. Overdrive Serum is interesting, but I don't think it's worth an inventory slot. Gives us the final melee weapon, but I'm actually most of the time I don't upgrade to the final version because that's the damage is pathetic for each of those weapons, right? So the current version I'm using, the Arc Blade, has a chance to stun enemies or disorient them, which is really nice. I've had situations when Chrysalid would come up to me, to my Blademaster Ranger, and he would just stun it so it couldn't attack them. And the final version has a chance to set enemies on fire, and like, yeah, if I'm moving in with a blade, I'm either going for the kill I just don't want to have a burning enemy who will then take damage, additional damage on his next turn. They don't survive that long. So I say, enemy, sorry for the rambling, we go for the Andromedon.
As initial,
or the proximity mines, I think it is. Right, we just got the improved, what just gonna call it, armor.
Commander?
Thanks. Yeah, one armor. Go.
This is our basic power armor frame, providing the durability you'd expect from a giant armored suit.
think she approves. Yeah, looking at this, I don't see us taking out a specialist anytime soon. Like, we don't have upgraded gremlins, we don't even have mech rifles, Nephilim plasma rifles. That's another, like, what, 400? Just for that. It's a shame. If a specialist could equip shotguns, that would make it really interesting, I'd say. So we want to build a Wraith suit. That's just a pure upgrade to the spider suit. No downsides.
Sounds good, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
And I think I also get a war suit going. I think, I mean, you lose an inventory slot when going from the normal armor to the warsuit, but if you, for example, use it on your grenadier, giving up one single grenade charge for your heavy weapon, for a blaster launcher or a shredstorm cannon, it's, I think, a trade I'm willing to do.
Strategic resource located.
Okay, 60 intel. I want to do this mission next, but I think I'm patient enough to wait two more days for the Wraith suit. So with that in mind, never mind, we don't have enough supplies.
Avenger plotting new course.
I think there was something else we could sell.
The market is open.
Superior expanded mech. Yeah, let's sell one of those. And get rid of the Vipers. Keep one Viper. $190 is enough for East Asia, right? Yes.
Setting course for East Asia.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as
I. Yes, proximity mine.
The fact that this armored environmental suit is capable of functioning.
From what I've been.
Now again, I mean, proximity mine is a nice item, although it sometimes seems a bit sketchy that it doesn't really hit. It doesn't hit everybody in the radius. Seems a bit odd, but it's a matter of the having the equipment slots for that again. Now, do I want to wait for the warsuit? I don't think so, because the warsuit doesn't really come with one of the heavy weapons. I think it comes with the default rocket launcher, which is just not good enough right now, I'd say. So. Yeah, never mind. We don't finish this kind of thing. We go for the black side. Data coordinates. The forge it is. Operation Blinding Cry. Andromeda, an elite lancer. Prototype sector pod. Okay. Lead officer, elite trooper, Archon, Muton, heavy mech, cheaper sectoid. Sounds doable. 13 enemies is a step up from what we had to deal with in the last few missions, but I'm sure our duo is up for the challenge. Okay, so I'm going to equip them and all, and I'll see you then next time. Have a good day.